Hello guys, welcome to our channel Shubhada Group of Education CC. You are watching this as physics videos for KCET and NEET. Look at a problem from electromagnetic induction or EMI. This is a problem from transformers. In a transformer, the number of turns in the primary are 140 and that in the secondary are 280. If the current in primary is 4 ampere, then that in the secondary is the question, correct? Suppose if you get the question from transformer, please try to remember this one. Number of turns in primary to the number of turns in secondary, that must be equal to the voltage or the potential or EMF across the primary to the EMF across the secondary. So it will be like this, EP divided by ES as well, which is inversely proportional to the current in current. So that is what, in secondary to the current in the primary. Okay, so now the number of turns in the primary is 140 divided by 280. That must be equal to the current in the primary is 4 ampere. We need to find out the current in the secondary. That is what, 4 ampere current. So it implies that IS must be equal to 1 by 2 into 4. That is what, 2 ampere current. So that's the reason why option B is the right answer for this question. The next problem says that in a step-up transformer, the turn ratio is 1:10. In the sense, number of turns in primary to the number of turns in secondary, that must be equal to 1/10. If a resistance of 200 ohm is connected across secondary, so that is RS must be equal to 200 ohm, and it draws the current. In the sense, IS in the secondary must be equal to 0.5 ampere current. The question is to find out the primary voltage as well as primary current, correct? So you know that to find out the value of the secondary primary voltage, we need to get about NP divided by NS. That must be equal to VP divided by VS, correct? So that's the reason why VP, let me make VS equal to, I have to use the Ohm's law here, VS equal to IS into RS, correct? So that's the reason why VP divided by IS is 0.5 ampere into 200. Correct? So that's the reason why this is going to be how much here? That must be equal to 1/10. That is what, NP divided by NS equal to 1/10. Okay, so that's the reason why, therefore VP must be equal to, VP must be equal to 1/10 into how much it is, 100, right? Into 100 equal to 10 volt. Okay, it must be 10 volt. So that's the reason why only in option B it is there. So they have asked you to calculate the value of the primary current as well, correct? Primary current. So to get that, what will you do? NP divided by NS must be equal to IS divided by IP. Okay, so it is what, 1/10 must be equal to, current in secondary is how much? Current in secondary is, now it is what, 0.5 divided by current in primary IP. It implies IP must be equal to 0.5 × 10. That is what, 5 ampere current. So it's 5 ampere current and 10 volt is the primary voltage as well as primary current respectively. The next problem says that when a current in a coil changes from 8 ampere to 2 ampere, okay, 8 ampere to 2 ampere in 3 × 10⁻²⁺ seconds. In the sense, T must be equal to 3 × 10⁻²⁺ seconds. Okay, the EMF induced in the coil is, induced EMF is how much? 2 volt is given. The self inductance L is equal to how much? In millihenry. Okay, the question is in terms of millihenry. Okay, so therefore, you know that induced EMF, let me take the magnitude here, L into di by dt, correct? This is our change in current to the change in time. So it implies L equal to induced EMF into dt divided by di, dt divided by di. Okay, so the self inductance L must be equal to, induced EMF is how much? 2 volt. The change in time is how much it is? That is what, 3 × 10⁻². And change in current is how much? It is changing from 8 to 2. In a sense, change is 6 ampere, correct? So 6 ampere. So 3 ones are, 3 twos are, 2 gone. We left with 10⁻². henry. So they ask you to calculate the value in terms of milli henry. So that's the reason why it is 10 milli. 10 into 10 to the power of minus 3 henry. That is what? 10 milli henry. Option D is the right answer for this question. Okay. The next problem says that the magnetic flux linked with the coil in Weber is given by the equation. The equation is pi equal to 5 t square plus 3 t plus 16. Okay, plus 16. The induced EMF in the coil in the fourth second is, you know that induced EMF equal to d pi by dt. Correct? So in the sense d by dt of 5 t square plus 3 t plus 16. So this is equal to 10t plus 3t. We need to calculate induced EMF. We need to calculate the induced EMF at t equal to 4, right? So 10 into 4 plus 3 into 4. That is what? 40 plus 12. That is what? 52 volt. 52 volt. That is not there, right? So just cross check it. Let's cross check it in the fourth second. In the fourth second, they ask you to calculate here. So it is not at all 3t here, just 3 here. Okay, so 5 10t, 10 into 4 is 40, 40 into 43, right? 43. So this must be equal to 40 plus 3, 43 volt. 43 volt. The nearest answer is 45 here. You can go for 45 volt here. The next problem says that a coil has an area of 0.05 meter and it has 800 turns. Okay, 800 turns. It is placed perpendicularly in the magnetic field of strength 4 into 10 to the power of minus 5 Weber per meter square or square meter. It is rotated through 90 degree in 0.1 second. The average EMF induced in the coil is the question here. Okay, so as you know that induced EMF must be equal to d pi by dt, actually negative sign due to the Lenz law. So therefore, so let me take the magnitude here. That is what induced EMF E equal to d pi by dt. As you know that, so here the value of theta is changing. First of all, it was perpendicular. So that's the reason why after that it is rotated by 90 degree. So in the sense, we must use pi is equal to b into a into cos theta. So that's the reason why I can say that b into a, as it has n turns, that's the reason why n b a. This is what? Cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2, as the theta is changing now, divided by dt. Okay, so therefore I can say that induced EMF E equal to number of turns is 800. The magnetic field is how much here? 4 into 10 to the power of minus 5. And the area of the cross section is 0.05. Area, and divide by the change in time. That is what dt is 0.1 seconds. The cos theta 1. First of all, it was perpendicular, right? So as you know that the area of is outwards, and since cos theta 1 is cos 0 degree, and after that it is moved 90 degree, in the sense cos 90 degree now, correct? So that's the reason why cos 90 is 0 and it is 1 here. So this will lead you to get the answer as 0.016 volt. So that's the reason why option D is the right answer for this particular question. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do subscribe to our channel. Please share this content as much as possible to with your friends, colleagues and all, and just to support us. And if you have any doubts, you can comment on the comment box so that I can help you with. Wish you all the best for examinations. Good luck. Thank you.